Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this unit, we're going to learn about a way to create mathematical patterns called sequences, starting with the most basic type, arithmetic sequences. On the surface, sequences are very simple. A sequence is a list of numbers following some pattern. You've seen them all over the place and you probably don't even realize it. For instance, here's a sequence that I'm sure you know, the even numbers. It's a sequence because each number is two higher than the last, following a clear pattern. Each of these numbers is called a term. The first number is the first term, the next is the second term, and so on and so forth. This seems pretty obvious right now, but it'll be very important to be able to identify the terms later on. There are many different types of sequences, but we're going to be starting with the simplest type, arithmetic sequences. In an arithmetic sequence, the pattern consists of adding or subtracting the same value over and over. The previous example, the even numbers, is an arithmetic sequence because the difference between consecutive terms is always 2. Another example would be this sequence here. Can you identify the pattern? From 11 to 8, you subtract 3. Same thing between 8 and 5. And between 5 and 2, and between every pair of consecutive numbers after that. This value that describes the pattern of an arithmetic sequence is called the common difference. Is this list of numbers, 4, 9, 14, 19, etc., an arithmetic sequence? An arithmetic sequence has a common difference, so let's check. From 4 to 9, we add 5. From 9 to 14, the difference is also 5. And again from 14 to 19. So this sequence has a common difference, meaning that yes, it is arithmetic. Then what's the next term in the sequence? Well, since the common difference is 5, if we take the last term, 19, and add 5 to it, we find that the next term is 24. What will the seventh term be? We have 5 terms so far. So we'll just need 2 more. If we continue by adding 5, the 6th term will be 29, and the 7th term is 34. These questions will need to be asked anytime you're trying to find more terms. First, is it even an arithmetic sequence? In this case, the first two terms have a difference of negative 4, the second and third terms have a difference of negative 4, and the third and fourth terms have a difference of positive 6. This sequence does not involve adding or subtracting the same number over and over again, so it's not an arithmetic sequence. This doesn't mean it's not a sequence at all, it's just that the pattern involves something other than constant addition or subtraction. Because we don't quite understand the pattern, we have no idea what the next term might be. And if we can't find the next term, then we also can't find the 6th, 7th, 8th, or 9th terms. Sequences can involve any numbers, including decimals, fractions, or anything else. That doesn't change the process at all. First, we see if the sequence is arithmetic by checking for a common difference. For this sequence, the common difference is subtracting 1.5. Now that we know the common difference, we can find the next term. Negative 2 minus 1.5 is negative 3.5. And we continue finding terms until we reach the one we want. The 7th term, the 8th term, and the 9th term. So the 9th term in this arithmetic sequence is negative 8. Arithmetic sequences are easy to identify and continue with more terms. And in the next video, you're going to learn how to describe them in mathematical notation. See you then!